Today in the Master of Crafts program, traditional paper cutting in the interpretation of a modern-day Ukrainian craftsman, large carved canvases with the tiniest details and a wide range of subjects, how the author's style that surprises art connoisseurs around the world was born. UATV continues its series of stories about Lviv craftsmen and explores traditional Ukrainian paper cutting, Vytynanky. Very often, restrictions only give creative people the impetus to self-realization. Master of Crafts has already told about the Kharkiv architect Dinara Kasko, whose passion for cooking made her a world-famous confectioner after her daughter was born. The same happened with a young sculptor from Lviv, who all of a sudden found herself in a completely different art. I learned to make traditional Ukrainian carved canvases from paper, vytynanky, but I also modernize them at the same time. That is, I exhibit them differently, with large canvases hung in space that create an interesting game of shadows. This is my style. Darya Alyoshkina has already created hundreds of meters of paper cutouts that truly boggle the mind. After all, these works of art are just paper with holes cut in it. Director of the Lviv Palace of Arts, Yuri Gnatkovsky, says that he has never before seen anything that resembles Darya's art.
Взагалі майстерність художника полягає у тому, щоб часом зі звичайних,
The artist's skill lies in making a work of art from ordinary paper clippings that are made in kindergartens, which would take you to a different world and evoke an emotional response. A vytynanka can be surprisingly deep, tender, and sensual. How did carving on paper become one of the most influential applied arts in history? What prompted Darya Alyoshkina to create these incredible canvases? You will find out about this intricate process next in the program. In the 8th to 9th centuries, the Chinese art of paper carving spread to Western Asia and only reached Turkey and the borders of Europe in the 16th century. Gradually, the Jianzi enriched itself with the local color of different countries. The Japanese style is called monkiri. In Mexico, it is the papel picado, which translates as packed paper. The first Ukrainian vytynanky are known from the 19th century in several historical regions, primarily in Podilia. Vytynanky were used to decorate homes, but they were very small and were hung on windows, doors and stove. That is, they were part of home decor. Sometimes they were put under glass, framed and hung on the wall as paintings. The ornamentation of traditional vytynanky is mainly geometric and vegetative. One can also create images of people and animals, as well as objects of everyday life, architecture and the like. The paper was folded 2, 4 or 8 times, which made it possible to create symmetrical compositions. That is exactly how paper snowflakes are made, used to decorate windows for Christmas and New Year's Day, which are known in many countries of the world. Darya Alyoshkina had never planned to be serious about vytynanky. I was born in Kiev, but grew up in the Vinnytsia oblast. My parents moved from Kiev to the Bukatinka village and began creating numerous works of art, the main ones of which were stone sculptures. There were also vytynanky among those, and that's one of the regions of Ukraine where they originated. I used to carve very simple compositions on paper when I was in elementary school. Darya's mother taught her to make paper cutouts, but the girl decided to become a sculptor like her father. 10 years ago, she graduated from the Academy of Arts and had held several sculptural exhibitions. But one day, I was given an empty hall with bare walls for the exhibition. I wondered how to decorate them to make them more vivid, because it looked very gray and morose. A week before the exhibition, I made 15 vytynanky and used them to decorate those walls. In the end, the visitors were more interested in the paper cutouts than in my sculptures. Soon, several of Darya's friends ordered vytynanky from her to decorate their apartments. The craftswoman had finally given sculptures up after marriage and the birth of her children. I had to work at home, which is difficult when it comes to sculptures. Stone was my main material, which was not very convenient in an apartment, because it's bad for the children due to all the dust. So I switched to paper. Vytynanky have really salvaged my creative personality and allowed me to realize myself.
саме мою творчість, моє творче виявлення під час материнства.
Paper cutouts proved very useful for Darya when she was into the Theater of Shadows together with her friends. The first such performances in Ukraine were done by her parents back in the early 1980s.
У них була дуже цікава формація, називалася театр.
The Theater of Shadows was a very interesting project. Darya recruited the actors herself. Some of the elements in it were decorations made out of Vytynanky from paper, cardboard, and so on. A team formed around that, which surprised the viewers with unusual performances that were mostly based on classic fairy tale. The Shadow Theater existed for 10 years, and now we're on a creative hiatus. But I was really interested in combining Vytynanky with theater to play with light and shadows. Of course, I would like to continue doing that, but I'm not stopping making paper cutouts. Today, both traditional Ukrainian motifs and all kinds of works of art, poetry, prose, painting, and music serve as inspiration for Darya. Special for UATV, the craftswoman demonstrates how such a simple, yet at the same time complex form of art is created. There are several types of Ukrainian Vytynanky. Open work is made out of one sheet of paper, making the image out of the parts that are cut out. There are also silhouette images. Ordinary Vytynanky are made out of one sheet of paper, and the more sophisticated ones are made out of several sheets of paper, so they are almost always multicolored. Usually, Darya makes open work and single-sheet silhouette compositions with symmetry along the vertical axis. She folds the sheet in half and begins cutting. First, I make a sketch in my notebook, and then I put it on a large sheet. I'm using black paper here. It is difficult to distinguish an ordinary pencil on it, so I'm using a white pencil. This way, I can easily see where to cut after the sketch is ready. Darya usually draws the main lines on the sketch and the small details on large canvases. Of course, it is always improvised. In order to not spoil the Vytynanka, the knife must always be sharp, especially since Darya uses dense paper, something in between office paper and cardboard. When it comes to cutting knives, the most important thing is the angle you sharpen it at. The ideal angle is 45 degrees. These blades break very often, so I constantly have to buy new ones. The paper is dense, so I have to press down very hard. One wrong turn can cost me a blade. Darya says that she would have made quadruple Vytynanky, that is, she would cut the paper folded four times if she had the strength for that. That is why her images are always double. I also use spirals very often. It's like a spiral of life, development, perpetual movement, infinity. It is one of my favorite symbols. What is left from cutting out spirals can later be used in other works, which is why I keep such cutouts. Spiral shapes can also often be seen on pisankas, Ukrainian painted eggs. Such folk ornaments are made not just for beauty. However, Darya is more focused on her associations and feelings when making Vytynanky. Although she is not always able to fully concentrate, as her four-year-old son, N.A., thoroughly enjoys watching how his mother executes her creative work. Here I used a lily flower as the basis. Here we can see silhouettes of two women. I like making something unusual on their head. I'm often asked, why two women exactly? But it's the same as one for me. It's just that a woman can be different and still remain herself at the same time. Faces can often be seen in the works of Darya Alyoshkina. They are mainly surrounded by vegetation. It is a tree with many branches, as if in late autumn all the leaves had fallen and only one remained, as if it was a silhouette of winter that is approaching. In the middle, a silhouette of a heart appeared accidentally. There is one interesting feature of Vytynanky, which I really like. When you unfold it, images you had not planned at all appear. It is bewitching, and every time I wait to finish the work so that I can see what I have actually created. There are also modern images in the Vytynanky of Darya Alyoshkina. For example, this composition called Change the Cassette is a recollection of the craftswoman childhood.
я собі згадую своє дитинство, десь 90-ті роки.
It was the beginning of the 1990s. I liked drawing, while some cassette was constantly playing. To not break away from my work, I asked my brothers and sisters to change the cassette or flip it to the other side. It's a kind of a memory. My children don't know what a cassette player is. So this Vytynanka can be interpreted in a different way, as if this woman asks to change the cassette metaphorically. Perhaps she's asking someone to change their attitude. That's the subtext here. Another big project is Vytynanky, based on the novel Vohnesmir by Ukrainian sci-fi writer and human rights activist Oles Burdnik. During the time of the Soviet Union, this man was involved in the founding of Ukrainian Helsinki Group and was persecuted by the KGB. Today his works come to life in 2-meter carved canvases, which the daughter of the writer will put on display in the National Museum of Ukrainian Literature. It can take weeks to create one. Darya Alyoshkina lost count long ago of how many such huge Vytynanky she has made over 10 years.
Як не то ту куманицю сіяв, тоді ми ся любувати почали. А ще то та куманиця не зійшла, як вже наша вірна любов розі. А ще то та куманиця не зійшла, як же наша вірна любов розійшла.
Darya Alyoshkina is sure that the revival of traditional applied arts, such as carving on paper, has already happened in Ukraine. When I just started in 2008, an art historian told me that the art of Vytynanky had been considered as dying out back then. Now they're becoming fashionable, and there are many young craftsmen interested in them. They study both the traditional techniques and try their own ideas. I think the true revival has begun. It's a new way. If new generations practice it, then this unique art form will live on for eternity.
Зараз тільки воно піде вгору.